Today I'm making a Darth Revan mask. Revan? Ravine? Raven? Raven's a Sith! Oh my god, this explains so much!
For this build, you'll need Plastidip, thin EVA foam, thin craft foam, foam core, green putty, a heat gun, silver rubbing buff, 2-liter soda bottle, sandpaper, white glue, hot glue, paint, nightshade spray paint, a sharpening stone, a respirator mask, goggles, sponge brushes, a rotary tool, scissors, razor pens, or a box cutter. First, cut this general shape from the EVA foam. I'd give you measurements, but I just totally eyeballed it, so unless you got one of them Loki eyeball-eating machines, I really can't help you. Heat it up with the heat gun. Be careful not to hover over the same spot for too long, because you'll burn the foam. While it's malleable, round it out. Glue the seam together slowly with hot glue. Hit it again with the heat gun to get the rounding just right, but be careful not to heat up the seam, because you'll reactivate the hot glue. Cut the visor plate. It's 3x10 inches, but I cut the corners off the bottom. Cut a 1/2 inch slot in it to see out of. So I know I've seen transparent black plastic folders somewhere, but couldn't find them in like any office supply store. So for the visor, I cut a strip of plastic from a soda bottle. Then I tacked it down to a sheet of cork board, cleaned it off, and painted it with nightshade spray paint. While it was drying, I traced the visor slot onto the mask and cut it out. I made it a little bit wider than the outside one. Then I cut, heat formed, and attached a panel. Then I made those little respirator nozzles at the bottom. Gotta say, villains in the Star Wars universe are really health conscious about their lungs. I don't blame them. That is one smoky, dusty, disgusting universe. By this time, the visor was dry, so I hot glued it to the mask. Let the glue cool for a moment before you set the plastic directly on it, because if it's still super hot, it could melt and warp the plastic. Nice. See, this is just practice for when I eventually get around to making Daft Punk helmets. I used thin black craft foam for one of the panels. You can also use this craft foam to make those cheekbone side panels if you want to, although I'm not sure those actually exist. It's kind of hard to tell what Darth Revan's mask is actually supposed to look like, because it's depicted differently across the games and the comics, but just make something that looks like a Cylon with a nosebleed and you should be fine. I put down blue painter's tape to protect the visor later from glue, dust, paint, blood, sweat, and tears. I know it's gonna be hard to peel off because it's a little bit wider than the outer slot, so I taped over a rubber band to use as a handle. Then I carefully glued down the visor plate. This will take a lot longer to do properly than my editing would lead you to believe, so just be aware of that. There's this rim that protrudes from below the visor on this mask, so build it back up with craft foam. You could also cut and sand some scrap EVA, but more work for the same effect. Not really into it. Now coat it in 5 layers of watered down white glue. Side note, I already heat formed and coated the inside of the visor opening on the outer visor plate before I did this, because sometimes wet glue and paint can seep underneath painter's tape depending on which brand you use, and I didn't want to take the chance that I was going to have to deal with that. Other side note, if you didn't draw any Sharpie lines on this and you're cool with just covering the seam at the top with a generic Sith hood, then you could forego the whole sealing, putty, sanding, gray base coat, all of that, because this mask is supposed to be a dull gray with faded red accents, and this type of EVA foam already comes dull gray that will absorb just enough red paint naturally. But alas, I did draw Sharpie lines, so you know. To get the glue to dry faster, you can use a hairdryer and a box fan. I didn't film this, but I put putty on the seam, sanded it flat, and then put another coat of white glue over top of it to cover any areas where I sanded right down to the foam. While that was drying, I glued in these foam belt loops to hold down the strap, which actually came from a knee pad, by the way. Then I mounted it on this dummy head and skewered it onto a pike for painting. Give it a base coat of gray, then use painter's tape to mask off the appropriate areas and paint it red. You don't want it to be a super vibrant red, because this mask is supposed to be super old and battle-worn. When you're finished, peel off the painter's tape, including the strip that's over the visor. Sweet. Then use Rub and Buff metallic finish on all the edges to simulate paint chipping. You can also use acrylic black on all of the areas that would accumulate dirt, but I didn't. And there you go, one Darth Revan mask. Now go start a Jedi Civil War. You know, for funsies. Hey, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this and want to see more tutorials, you can follow these links in the annotations or in the cards if you're on a mobile device. And you can subscribe for more content, or all of those options. If you want to help me make quality prop tutorials more often, then you can head on over to the Patreon page where patrons enjoy early uploads. Which Star Wars mask or helmet is your favorite? Let me know in comments below. Shake out.